So the last part from this chapter is called component of force. Okay. Actually, from most of the question, the first part they will ask you what is the resulting force. Okay. Given several forces, like we have seen from the previous example, given several forces, and then you need to calculate what is the resultant force. But at the end, they want you to resolve this resultant force into axis which is not x and y. Okay, maybe normally they will call it as AA, BB or something. Okay, given any axis, you have to resolve that one into the given axis. Okay, so the concept is, you just imagine this one, the first one. This is the simple axis which is x and y. So to resolve f into fx and fy, you have to make sure that the f is in between two resolving force. That's what I have already explained in my previous video. So my fx will be here. Fx, this is fy. Okay, now I'm having the same force but different axis. Okay, let's say this question wants you to resolve into axis AA and BB. Okay, so you have to make sure that your resultant force is in the middle. So your choice is either from here to front, down, front or back for BB, or up or down for A. If you choose this one, this direction, of course, your RF is not in between this one. So you have to choose the first one here is there. This is FBB. The second one must, if you use this one, there's nothing here. So you must use this direction, FAA, so that your resultant force, original force, is in between these two resolving forces. Okay, this example, then we have to choose same as here. We have FBB, and to this direction, FAA. Okay, so from here, you have the SF, and this is the angle. So you have FAA, the other one is FBB. Okay, so notice that here that you have 1, 2, 3 forces. Okay, and then you can do F equal to, this is F equal to FAA plus FBB, and then you can calculate using the angle given what is the value of AA and BB. Normally, in this case, if FAA and BB is unknown, or we already have two unknown, all other angle will be given to you so that you only stick to two unknown for simplification of this chapters. Okay, so we will give you all the angle, but sometimes it's complicated, you have to calculate from the given other angle, but normally it is easily for you to calculate that one. And then your only unknown is AA and BB. Okay, so we look at some example for that one. So one simple example for component of force, we can have this exercise. Okay, let's see this exercise. Exercise 2.6. Okay, this one. So, yeah, 2.6. Okay, we look at this example. So the question said that determine the component of force F, 100 Newton, okay, along AA and BB axis. So we have this one is F. What we need to have now is what is FAA and what is FBB. Okay, so you have the F. So now your first job is to resolve the F into FAA and FBB. So the axis that we have is, one is A here, one is B. So we make sure the F is in the middle. So of course, this is FAA. This is FBB. Okay, so normally using this method, I will choose to use the trigonometry method, because we have the F1 plus F2 equal to B. We know the angle, but the FAA and FBB is unknown. Okay, it is easy for you to use the trigonometry. It's also rectangular component also can be used, but in my case, normally I will choose the trigonometry. Okay, so cos can help me know directly from here. F, all the direction is known, so it's easy for you to use this trigonometry. F equal to F A A plus F B B. Okay, so I need to first draw what is the F A A. F A A from here. This is F A A. Here is the angle is 30, so of course here is also 30. Okay, and then the next one is you didn't know where it's finished because the magnitude you didn't know, but you know that at the end they will add the FBB, which is straight upward. This is FBB. Okay, so FAA you didn't know, it just go somewhere. Okay, so at the end you add the FBB and you know that the result is from, this is your start point to the end point somewhere here, you don't know, but it is given to you already the direction, which is 45 degree. So this is the F here is 45 degree. Okay, so actually you know exactly the direction of each component, and you, the thing that you didn't know only the magnitude of this one. Okay, or if you want to put here like the table before, F A A plus F B B equal to F. So you have this table just to check. This is F A A, F B B, F 100, 45 degree, F B B upward, F A A downward, 30 degree. Okay. So clearly to you, you have two unknown, FAA and FBB. Okay, so now. Okay, so you can use cosine and sine rule, which is sine A divided by A equal to sine B divided by B and so on. Or cos A squared equal to B squared plus C squared something, cosine rule. Okay, so to use that one, we have two unknown. Here is, we know already, here is 100. So our two unknown is FAA and FBB. Okay, angle here is known, so you can put all the known angle. This is 30, this is 30, so this is 90 degree because it's straight. So it leaves you to 60 degree. Okay, this is 45, so here is also 45. 90 degree there, so this one is also 45. Okay. 45, 45, 90, this is 90, so add up everything is 180 degree. Okay, so if you want to use the cosine rule, for example, you know this one, but FB, FA is zero, no. So it is complicated, so you might want to use the sine rule. So I will use, because now I know that this F and this angle, okay, or these two is known, so I might use the sine with this one, because the angle here is already known, so I can get the FBB. So sine this inside 45 plus 30 75 divided by FBB equal to sine 60 divided by 100. So you have the FBB equal to, okay, so FBB, this direction, so sine divided by this two. Sine 60 equal to divided by 100 equal to, so I will have sine 75 divided by all this down, answer equal to FBB 111.53. Okay, the direction is already known, this direction. Okay, so now I can continue the same method for the FAA. So, sine 45 divided by FAA equal to sine 60 divided by sine 60. sin this one. Cos 60. Okay, so sin 60 is okay. Sin 60 divided by 100. So same, you have FAA equal to sin 60 divided by 100. Same. And then put everything down this one. So sin, I will use sin 45 divided by answer. You have 81.65 meters, and the direction is 30 degrees. Okay. Okay. As simple as that. Question asks you what is determine the component of force along AA and BB. So we have AA and BB. So the first thing that you really need to know is how to resolve this one, which direction. So you need to really focus on the original force must be in between the two resolving forces, and then you can come up with this. Or you, if you want to use the rectangular component, you can resolve from here and calculate also can. Or if you want to use trigonometry method, you can solve for trigonometry. Normally for me it's easier for you to use the trigonometry method. Okay, but it's not wrong to use this one. You can choose. And you can try which one suit you best. Okay, so that's all for the last part of this chapter.